So what does creative destruction look like? I want you to get back in your way, way, way back time machine and imagine a life without a smartphone. And I know this is really hard to do, but in a time far, far away, there used to be this stuff called film. And you'd put film into a camera that was a device separate from your phone. And after you took a certain limited number of pictures, you had to take this film to a store to be developed. You had to wait for days. Then you had to get back in your car, drive to the store, pick up your pictures. And 2 to 3 out of your pictures were terrible anyway. They were blurry. People weren't looking at the camera. And then someone came along and developed the first digital concept. It was new, innovative, evolutionary, and revolutionary. And when asked what they thought of this new digital concept, top leadership at Kodak, a film company, the film company, said, "It'll never work. They'll never be able to develop pixels well enough to compete with us. We're fine. We'll always be on top." And then people innovated more, developed more, and created a pixel capacity better than the world could have ever dreamed of. This is creative destruction, the next best way to do things. Guess who wasn't happy about this? Kodak. People who had jobs there, people who developed the film, the innovation, creative destruction was painful for these people. They were out of jobs. They had to reinvent themselves, find new careers. This is scary and uncertain. But what did that creativity provide for everyone else? People, families, a brand new revolutionary way to live your life. A new way to capture memories, make moments last longer. You can relive a great achievement, like a graduation or winning a championship game, again and again. And as creative destruction continued, you now have access, instant access to these memories in your pocket. Real leaders, great entrepreneurs, are excited by creative destruction. This means revolutionizing society, innovating and creating value and serving others with new ways to make people's lives better. Here is how leaders understand creative destruction. From a sheer language perspective, do you want to know why I love the term creative destruction? Because you have two words, creative and destruction, and these two words could not have more polar opposite meanings. Take the word creative. How do you feel when you hear that word? You feel good, warm, fuzzy, inside. Creative evokes feelings of hope, inspiration, optimism about the future, visions of a better tomorrow, and a better way of doing things. And then you have the word destruction. How does that word make you feel? Not great, right? Destruction brings up feelings of anxiety, fear, uncertainty, unease. But something really powerful happens when you put these two words together, creative and destruction. You acknowledge that any step forward, any innovation, any new solutions, as exciting and as hopeful as they might be, comes with a certain amount of pain, a certain amount of fear, a certain amount of anxiety, and probably even a certain amount of failure. The proper role of leaders and entrepreneurs in a free enterprise society is to respect and satisfy the customer and to innovate, to create a better future. Not go to government and ask government to try to stop your competitors or to tax your competitors more or to slap a regulation on them. No. You succeed as a leader, as an entrepreneur, by constantly, creatively destroying to get to the next best version of yourself and the next best version of your idea, innovation, and company. The exceptional leaders in life know this, and they identify the opportunity, persevere, headstrong through their challenges, and they drive themselves, their companies, and everyone around them creatively toward the next best version of the things that they're working on or the people that they want to be. Because if you aren't creatively destroying yourself, your company, your products, your services, your competition, listen to what I'm saying, your competition will destroy you. And it should, because that means they're serving people better than you. They're creating more value for society than you are. As a whole, creative destruction improves people's lives and makes people in society better off. Creative destruction is an invitation for you to lead your community and society to a better tomorrow.